Okay. So, based on the video, what have you noticed? No, what is he talking about? Although we cut the video into 3:54 minutes in, the video no gin pause ko lang, pero in the very beginning I yung discuss until the recent one where you see the top export sa each country in the world, no, here in this map, no. So what do you think, no, ang iyang topic is all about, no, kaniyang ipang discuss, iyang ipang mention, anyone? Okay, so I'll ask. Okay, I'll choose a random individual to share their thoughts. Okay, so I'll ask Janlin. So based on video just a while ago, and then syempre, nakapin. Sorry. Based on the what you see on the screen, no, it's a map of each country's top export. What do you think is the video about? Although gin-cut ko lang no early in the video, pero what do you think is the video all about? Okay, so si Gamboa is raising her hand. Okay, let's go back to Janlin. So Janlin man to ang akong gi-mention kanina. Okay lang, sige. You try to fix your internet kay basin sa connection mo, miss. How about Janlin? What do you think is the video about? So hindi man ko ano, hindi man tama nga response si Miss Janlin. Ah, dili ma-on ang mic. You can type your answer, Janlin, in case if you have audio problems so that I can just read your answer. So this one, no, this is still talking about localization, but it's a different kind of localization, which I will explain later on because probably you'll be confused, no? We're talking about localization and why are we into like this and that. Just to give you context, no, of what we are going to discuss and how different it is from the previous two lessons that we discussed just last week, no? So we discussed lesson 3 and 4. It's a different kind of localization, L10N. This one is another different kind of explanation on localization, but it's more on localization and industry, which I will explain further later on. So, while we wait, no, for Janlin and Gamboa to type their answers, no, okay. So Janlin, I think the video is all about Miss exportation in different country. I think it's okay. So it is exportation, no? And when you talk about exportation, it means what is the kind of product that you specialize in, or kung sa to pang language, no? Daw amo na siya ang damo nga resources sa ato ang gina-export. Syempre, since we are not hindi man necessarily kita ang sole producer ana, kami iban man nga countries nga ga-produce ani nga product. You take for example coal or sugar or car parts, no, or clothing or electrical energy. Damo man in every country maka-provide ana nga resources, but knowing that you are the major producer because mas daghan, no, mas damo ang sa inyo nga country compared to other countries, and that is like your specialization, though that's the kind of product that you specialize in, no? Take for example here in the Philippines, what do you think is the specialized product of Negros Occidental? Now we discussed in the previous lessons, no, nga we encounter before we entered localization. Diba, ano ganito ang ato ang major product diri sa Negros Occidental other than lumber, other than fish, no? Or aquaculture, ano ganito? That's why we are known as the what? The blank bowl of the Philippines. No, ito to major na to nga export. It's sugar. No, so sugar is our main export, main product natin sa Negros Occidental. Now, why are we talking about exports when we are still in localization? Diba, supposedly, it's in globalization unta, no? Pero, nga, why are we talking about exports, countries specializing in different products? Nga, it's in globalization man unta. Now, we are going to talk tonight about localization in industry. Ang localization in industry is as a different kind, a different context compared to the localization that we encountered in lesson 3 and 4.
On ko lang ang charger.
So for lesson 3 and 4, di ba, we talk about localization. Just a recap in case you have already forgotten, ano, kay it's been a week naman since our last meeting. So, localization or L10N is it's a business strategy wherein, for example, you are an international or global brand and you want to introduce your product to the Philippines. So you either adapt your product that will fit the culture or translate your product to Filipino so that it would fit the culture of a certain country, no? Take for example, like what I've said last time, no? Take for example, your Dunkin' Donuts and you want to introduce your product to the Philippines. So, if you're going to apply localization strategy, you're going to provide toppings sa Dunkin' Donuts, for example, like adobo toppings, or for example, ubi halayang flavor, something that speaks Filipino, even though it's Dunkin' Donuts, it's an international brand, but you adapt your product, you translate, you adapt the entire physical and even ang flavor niya tanan to fit the culture of the country that you're selling your product to. And if you go to Saudi Arabia, lahi man nilang food dito, lams lay ubi halaya and adobo dito, knowing sa halal, dapat halal ang ato ang foodie offer dito sa mga Muslim country. So, dates flavored nga mga donuts, di ba? Or sa China, katong pork and seaweed nga donut, no? Savory nga desserts ilaha dito. So, mo ng localization or L10N nga strategy in business. But the localization that we are going to talk about tonight is about localization in industry. What does it mean? Mayingon gay tag localization in industry, it means that unsa gina specialize sa certain region or sa certain country. Like in the Philippines, localization in industry means that we localize the sugar plantation, sugar, I don't know if it's manufacturing, mag sugar production din, no? Sugar production because daghan kaayog sugar plantations here in Negros Occidental, no? That's localization in industry. Like, although we can make sugar in other places in the Philippines, pero mag-localize ta sa tong industry, sugar industry, in Negros Occidental because kung may ilang lands, volcanic, di ba? Remember atong discussion sa cultural background in Negros Occidental? Previous lesson na to, no? Mga lesson 2, nga, the soil in Negros Island is volcanic, meaning it is suitable for agriculture. Therefore, angay jud ang mga sugar canes nga in-nurture dito because muna, no? Ideal man ang climate, ideal man ang soil. So, muna siya nga na-localize ang sugar industry in Negros Occidental. We specialize in sugar. That is why we are called the Sugar Bowl of the Philippines. So, kung magtala po kasalain nga lugar, ilahay na po nga localized industry dito is rice. So, lahi na ni akong gi-discuss nga term ha, so that you will not be confused. Mayingon gani kog localization in industry. No? I will type it in the chat box so that you can, it's not in my slides, mga gano. Localization in industry. If you talk about localization in industry, what but silingon ana no is that ko ana siya kanang you specialize no specialization niya na. Okay, so asa mo sa guy fishing no kay we are found near sa mga ko ano sa lapit sa dagat no coastal areas. So mo na among localization in industry or before na exhaust or na wala tanan ang mga dagko nga mahogany trees sa sagay, our localization in industry is lumber. O ingana no, so mo na siya ang localization in industry. Lahi po tong localization in business nga what I talked about in lesson 3 and 4, which is taking a global product and translating it or adapting it to a certain country para mo fit silang character, silang culture. Okay, para mas dali ni mo sila mapa-accept, no, or mumubay sa imong product. This one is more on geographical concentration on a certain region nga sila lang ana ang mass producers kay tungod damo na sa ilahang lugar or there are so many resources in that area. Diba? So, mupo na siya. Okay? Ano itong, like, sa Toledo daw, kuan man na sila, no? Sa mining man na sila. So, ilang localization in industry is mining. Daw mga specializations in each region. So, it's important that I introduce to you that context because in my slides, diretso manggod siya factors and advantages in localization. So, syempre, no, if dili ta maghatag context on what localization in industry means, you'll be confused. So again ha, separate na ni siya nga concept because it talks about localization in industry. So localized na pud ta no, wala na pud ta atong i-discuss ato sa 3 and 4 nga from international gin localize siya para ma-embrace ang kaninga product, kaninga brand. Kani, localization in industry, edit ko lang siguro nyo para hindi ka mo ma-confuse. This is more na on specializations, geographic concentrations, man siya. So, we are now living in a world of globalization. Businesses have ceased to develop their commerce inwards and started to embrace the new trend of internationalization. After all, the more consumers are able to reach, the higher chances of attracting better sales. On the contrary, does this mean that there's no advantage in localized business anymore? We will find out. So, we talked about global businesses, internationalization, globalized business, going, reaching out into other countries so that they can spread the presence of their business. That was L10N. But in localization and industry, it means that there is still an advantage in localized business because it provides several opportunities, no? So, in order to keep up with the changes in the business industry, and it's very expensive, no? If you do outsourcing, although, ano kayo at man sa, naman po advantages ang outsourcing, no? Because you will be guaranteed of the best and quality jud nga products, pero sa localization in industry, small businesses can also, no, make their own international presence. So, on the other hand, there are disadvantages and advantages of having a globalized market. And it will depend on the market of or type of service, rather, no, or products your company are offering. Therefore, it is safe to assume that localized businesses still have some advantages. So, before we'll proceed to the advantages and disadvantages, for your learning outcomes, you will be able to determine the advantages and disadvantages of localization of industries and determine the factors that influence industry localization. So, may ha, localization of industries na taron, no? So, this is different na from what we discussed from the two previous lessons. So, the important factors which influence the localization of industries are discussed in the next slide. So, The factors that introduce localization in industry is first the nearness to raw material. Picture out Negros Occidental, no? So that's an example. So one of the very important factors which affects the birth of an industry is the certain in certain areas is the nearness to the sources of raw material. Why would we have a sugar production or kanang factory baron, for example, sa sugar dito sa Manila nga mas daghan man, no, mas damo man diri sa Negros Occidental. At the same time, sige, ito ibutan kay sentro man jud ang Manila, no, duol na siya sa supermarket. But you have to consider it would be very costly to transport raw materials to Manila or ito sa Luzon from Negros Island. So that would, no, kanang be a disadvantage po. Kay it would mean nga ang pagpresyo po ana nga finished product or final product, let's say refined sugar or brown sugar, mo expensive po siya. Kay syempre li mo pud pwede mo baligya ka alkansi ka, di ba? You have to also consider the cost that you cost na yung nagasto from transporting raw materials, ang mga tao pa nga nag-transport ana, di ba? And even, you know, the vehicles, tanan, no? All the processes getting your raw materials from the province to the city. So, with localization, no? Ang localization is, itukod na lang siya ang kanang industry near raw material so that it would reduce the transport cost, no? And also the total cost of the production, no? Para cheaper na lang siya, no? So this is due to the reason that most of the industries are established in regions where the raw material is available in abundance. So you've noticed, no, kalabanan sa mga dagko nga factory or mga dagko nga kuan, dira na lang sila duol kung asa ang raw material so that wala na'y daghang gasto, no? Kinsa ang pagginahan nga daghang gasto mo, mahal sa mo't ilang product, no, ilahang end product, and then costly pa ang ilahang production cost, no? So, ang ending ana, kung mumahal, di, dili ginahan mo palit po ang consumers, di ba? So, yung ana rin na siya, no? Another factor that affects localization, why other regions, no, they localize industries, like diri na lang sa Negros ni siya, or diri na lang sa Cebu, is also the availability of source of power. So, mga power resources like electricity. So, dili na kinahanglan nga ma-carried over to long distance where the industry or is located or the coal which serves as raw material to be transported at a far off distance where it is extracted. Dili na siya ma-carried over for longer distance. Nga expensive siya, no? Similar sa kung dimension kanina, mo-travel pa siya dugay, no? Ma-delay pa ang pag-produce sa imuhang mga raw materials, kay syempre, ibiyahe pa man siya, wapot ang kabalo sa acts of God, no, nga mga situations like bagyo, ba? Diba? So, instead nga, you will be productive, like you will finish several products in this week, madelay siya, og pila kasi man na because na ibagyo, no, madelay ang pag-deliver sa imong raw materials. So, mapuna, no, nga, na na-localize na lang ang mga industries in regions nga asa ang daghag raw materials and na ay available source of power so that they will not travel far na lang, di ba? So, physical and climate conditions. So, we always have to go back to the example of Negros Occidental. The main reason why we export not only sugar, no, but also before, no, kung wala pa to siya nasirado sa Maysilay, asipalay ang mga kuan, no, mga natural minerals, no, at the same time kanang mga aquaculture, lumber, other agricultural products such as kanang fruits, vegetables, poultry. So daghan kayo tag ma-export, no, and then dili man lang na siya sugar ang ato ang main localized industry. Daghan man putag mga localized industry nga kitay gana ka-produce, no? So, due to the physical and climate conditions, no? So, dako kaayon na siya nga factor nga, no, ga-exist, no, ang sugar plantation or sugar industry sa Negros because of the climate conditions, no? Like, okay man ang panahon diri sa ato, even ang soil na to is volcanic for the entire Negros Island, no? So, mas more na noon suitable, no, for agriculture. So, muna siya, no? For example, suitable diri nga nay fishing industry ani nga region sa Philippines kay open seas man ni ilaha nga region, no? Daghang bodies of water, no? Daghan dirig mga isda nga magtapok. So, dili man dali mahubsan, no, og mga isda. So, it's good for fishing industry, o mga ana. No? So, magdepende. Or for example, in this region, daghag mga for example, like fossil fuels or oil, no? Nga pwede ni mo na siya imina, himuon ni mo na siya krudo, no? So, depende na sa natural resources available in that place. That's why dira na ma-localize, no, ang ilahang industry. Why do you think ang salad bowl is ang kuan? Kung kasi masayop tayo. Kay tungod sa ilang climate cold dito, no, suitable for okay. So, ang Highland Province, no? Salad Bowl of the Philippines, ang Cordillera Mountains. So, dool-dool dyan sa, kung ano, sa Baguio, no? Sa Benguet, no? Because, not only nga mountainous siya, no? Pero lang climate kay medyo cold, dili kay nga nakainit, no? Suitable ilang climate for vegetable. So, kung lang kita mo sa katong telenovela nila ni, kung ano, sikat kasi Liza Rono, kay chika kay siya karon sa mga tao. At ang telenovela nila ni Liza Soberano, itong pinakauna niya nga telenovela na sikat siya sa ganito, nalimot na ko. College pa ko ato. Diba sa Benguet man ito nakakuha, no? Itong na ay mga strawberries, na ay mga dagko kayo nga cauliflower, no, mga carrots, tanan. So, sila ang gitawag sa salad bowl of the Philippines. Kaya daghan kayo dito og mga fruits and vegetables nga dagko kayo ilang tubo. At the same time, even mga kuan nga mga sana ka ng mga fruits nga mo live lang sa medyo colder nga climate like strawberries, although naan po diri sa Don Salvador, no, pero lahi ra jud ang gikan jud dito sa Benguet, di ba? Mas dagko rito ilaha dito, no, given their climate. So muna nga ilahang localized industry is agriculture, no. So muna ang La Trinidad ang localized industry nila is what? Strawberry. Kay daghan kay sila strawberry plantation nga maoy gina export, di man gina export pero ginapadala sa mga different regions in the Philippines, no, because of their big and ano kanang sweet nilang strawberry. So muna siya, no. Also, the physical climate can encourage localization of an industry. So again ha, mag-vary ang localization of industry sa kada lugar. Kay may iban man nga lugar nga dili suitable ilang climate for agriculture, pero daghan man sila cold dito og natural resources. So ilang localized industry is mining. Naapoy localized industry nga fishing para sa inyo sa sagay, di ba? Kay dool man sa coastline, dool sa dagat. Mapo na siya. So, nakagets lang, students.
Yes, miss.
Okay. So, let's proceed to nearness to market. So, dili ni market nga merkado ha. When we talk about market, it's your consumers, your customers. So, industries have the tendency to be localized in those areas where the market is near at hand. Meaning, potential customers ka sure gid nga mag-buy sa inyuhang products, no? Dira ka magbaligya. Kaya syempre, no, daw kumansan sa lang in business, diba? Ikaw kung mag-sell ka og school supplies sa merkado, no, although daghan man magtong merkado or mo sell because school supplies sa dool sa cemetery, no, syempre wala jay magpalit, no. If you want to sell school supplies, you go to near schools, di ba, near universities, and then lahi na pud na, no, depende na sa imuhang type of target market. Your target market is your idealized nga kuan nga customer. So for example, no, you want to have a clothing business. So your target market are teenagers nga mga babae, no, because ang imuhang mga sinaibaligya are for female man. So that is your target market. Like, kinsa man akong baligyaan, kinsa man ang ako ang i-advertise akong mga products, no. Syempre kung target market mga dalaga jud, no. Kaya akong mga products kay sa Shein, sa Laura nga mga sinina, o oh, ingan na. So industries have a tendency to be localized in those areas where the market is near at hand. The goods produced can be easily brought in the market and can be much saving in the cost of transportation. So just like what I've said, no? Like for example, your target market are living in Cebu, pero ang imuhang pahimuan, no? Or your factory is located in Panay Island, no? So kalayo man, diba? No, so kinanglan you when you consider localizing an industry, no, you have to be near the market, because that's one of the factors why there is a localized industry, because it's needed in the market, no? Dool siya sa consumers. Okay, supply of trained labor. So one of the factors why there's also localized industries is also supply of trained labor. Meaning, okay, so I've noticed, no, in the recent data, damo man tourism and hospitality schools here in San Carlos City, no, ang Santa Rita ga offered tourism, CPSU ga offer HM, and then puhon ng other schools mag-offer pod sila ana nga program. So meaning, if magtukod ko og hotel in San Carlos City, it will be okay for me, no, because I will have a supply of trained labor who are graduates of hospitality management, tourism management nga mag-work sa akong hotel. So I will no longer have to hire people from Bacolod, from other padjud nga mga municipalities and cities nga kalayo man sa San Carlos, kay naa na may mga graduates mismo from that program nga pwede makatrabaho sa akong hotel. Sumupo na siya ang reason where there is a supply of where there is localized industry. Like why nga magtukod og mga factories or magtukod og hotels, kay magdepende pud sa trained labor. Untrained labor is skilled workers, no, in that particular field. Okay? So syempre dili man ta ka tukod og hotel sa San Carlos kung walay mga graduates of HM or tourism. Mag-hire kag layo, do you think, no, mo travel pag gidna ang uban nga mga taga layo just to work in your hotel nga may naa may hotel pud sa Bacolod or in other areas, diba? No, so mapod na siya. So availability of capital. Industries may spring up in those areas where capital is available at a lower rate. Most especially if it's like a developing city pa. Ano ka nang padulong? First class ba tawag ana? Class C, class B nga mga cities nga dili man jud noon pareha sa Cebu or sa Bacolod or sa Iloilo kadagko na siya nga city, pero ga-develop pud siya, no, kita nila nga okay, it's feasible to establish a localized industry diri because or here because kuan man, no, kanang ang capital is ano man lower rate, cheaper compared to bigger cities na mas mahal, no, ang needed ni mga capital, kay the bigger the city mas expensive biya, no. So dire, since developing man, damo man Japan population ang kaninga city, pero damo pod skilled labors and lower lang ang cost sa capital. So that is why may mga localized industry. And then momentum of an early start. So sometimes, no, kung wala ka competition, for example, no, nakita mo wala pa may nag-start og molasses or atibutang molasses or sugar industry diri nga area. Ako pa man lang, so muna I am encouraged to start a sugar plantation here, no, so that ako lang isa, wala ako competition, wala other sugar plantations or sugar company or milling company nga makakompete sa ako, and then manon na noon ang kaninga place. So for example Carmen, oh, for example, manon na noon ninga place ang Carmen for sugar industry. Maskin dili no kay nearby, near sa coastline man na ang Carmen, but anyway, no, just an example ba. No nga, ala, wala pa may nag-start diri og sugar industry sa Carmen, ako lang ang magsugod. No, not only cheaper ang capital diri, damo pod skilled laborers, no. At the same time, wala ako competition, di ako lang isa. At ako'y maka-introduce sa sugar industry here in Carmen, no. That's an example. Okay, why a lot of regions here, they have localized industries, no? So, we'll now start now, no, with our discussion on advantage and disadvantages of localization. So, we'll start first with the advantage of localization. First is reputation. The place where an industry is localized gains reputation, and so do the products produced there. As a consequent, articles bearing the name of that location find wide markets, such as Sheffield cutlery, Swiss watches, and Ludhiana hosiery. Sorry if I pronounce that wrong. No. So take for example, Switzerland is known for the best watches or milk or mobile, for example, no. Or kanang infamous kaayo nga ko ano. Sakto bang infamous no? Parang pinaka famous nila nga kanang logo sa Toblerone, no. So magdi man sa Switzerland man siguro ang Toblerone. Pero like milk or for example watches, no, mao na muna na ilang smart specialty. So mag-gain na ang reputation ni mong basag to kang Switzerland, they're known for this, for their watches, they're known for this and that. Or for example, if you go to Chicago, they're really known for their good deep dish pizza. O mga ingan na, no, reputation na ni mo, kaya na-localize na ni mo ng industry. Same good diri sa to as a Negros, diba? Our reputation as the sugar bowl of the Philippines. That is why gin-carry dyan na siya. No, nga reputation for wide kita jud ang kanang big producers of sugar. At the same time, in our tagline, no, Land of Sweet Surprises, so gin-adapt na nato na siya as our own identity as Negrenses, no. So muna na ang ato ang reputation, okay? So we are known na already for that kind of industry. Sa Christmas Capital, no, mumuna siya, no? Christmas Capital, Sugar Bowl, Salad Bowl, Rice Bowl of the Rice Bowl ba to? Or Rice Granary of the Philippines, no? Damo kayo siya. I forgot already kay in Philippine Geography and Tourism Culture, that is discussed man, no? Kaya mga different regions, ano ilang mga specialty, specialized industry. Okay, so skilled labor. So localization escorts to specialization in particular trades. As a consequence, laborers skilled in those trades are fascinated to that place. So the localized industry is continuously fed by a regular supply of skilled labor that also attracts new firms into the industry. Okay, take for example, you have the watch industry in Switzerland. So those who really love watches would go there. No, kay kuan man, kanang dira man jud ang ilahang industry jud dito. Or for example, those who would like to study fashion would go to Paris because the leading fashion icons, fashion brands are there, no? Chanel, Versace, no? Sa mga lain nga kuan, no? Ang Gucci is Italian man. Daghan pa many more na ako ma din ako kuan sa iba, no. So muna siya, no, more skilled labor are drawn into that place. That's an advantage, no, nga if you want to study fashion, you go there kaya dira man ilahang localized industry. If you are more into watches, you go to Switzerland. No, mabitaw na unsa gani na siya ang swatch, di ba? Ang sa swatch, no? Kanang mga Swiss watches. Basta gikang ginag Switzerland ang imong relo. Kuan dyan na, kanang dili-dali maguba, no? Kaya mo na ilang industry dito. Okay? Next one, growth of facility. So, focus of an industry in a specified region leads to the development of specific facilities there. To cater to the needs of the industry, banks and financial institutions open their branches where the firms are able to get timely credit facilities. So, for example, no, since nag-establishment taog sugar industry here in Negros Occidental, that means mas muasenso ang lugar around it. Like, na may mga pabahay, kasi syempre na may mga empleyado, anak nga, sugar milling company, di ba? Not only that, banks, no, syempre, asa man sila mukuha og funds, and mo invest silang money, no, in that kind of industry, no, capital pa nila and all, pasweldo sa mga tao, no, market, kaya syempre, kinahanglan man dyan, o kung ano, kay, ang mga family sa mga trabahante, asa man silang magpalit silang food, schools, no, for the families of the workers, no, healthcare center. So, because na ay industry na tukod dira, ma-develop pod ang usa ka syudad. Because there are people living there. If this is a localized industry, magtukod kag factory in a lugar nga few rag population, expect na nga managhan. Because, syempre, you will be hiring more people, more skilled workers, and magka-develop na siya because those people have needs as well. They need facilities, di ba? So, kinahanglan man nilag schools, hospitals, pabahay, merkado, fire station, police station, tanan, no? So, sentro siya of development. Okay, subsidiary industries. So, where industries are localized, subsidiary industries also grow to supply machine tools and implements and other materials to utilize their byproducts. Take for example, in the sugar industry, no? So, you need sugar machinery tools or, for example, machines, no? So, same sa kung gimension kanina, growth of facilities, na po yung mga facilities nga solely, factory sila nga maghimo arag machine for sugar, sugar plantation, or tools for sugar plantation. Kaya, syempre, muma na ang kuan dira. Muma na ang industry dira. Okay, next is employment opportunities. So, syempre, no, if there are industries kin patukod, no, like sugar plantation, or copra, no, or for example, lumber. Iba, nakita to ninyo ang pinakauna dyan, no, katong history of sagay, nga ning asenso ang sagay, daghan na noon kaayog nag migrate dito sa inyong lugar, sa sagay, no, coming from Bohol, coming from Cebu, coming from Panay Island and Guimaras, because there are numerous job opportunities given nga gagrow, no, ang inyong lumber industry dito. So same goes with the localized industry. If naipatukod nga factory, syempre, or factory or a milling company or a plantation or any other industry nga ga-produce og products, poultry, vegetables, crops, maski unsa pa na siya nga products, na dyan na yung employment opportunities. Okay? So, since naa na may localization of industry dira, nagipatukod, syempre, kailangan silang tao for that job, for that work. And that increases employment opportunities in the region, and if na ay trabaho, can also help, no, in sustaining the economy, no, or the economic health of that municipality or of that city. Diba? So, mauna siya ang unsa sa advantages po of localization in industry. Lahi na po ni siya nga localization, ha? Hindi mag-confuse. Okay, common problems. So, all concerns form as association to solve their common difficulties. This connection secures various types of facilities from government and other agencies for expanding business, established research labs, publishes technical and trade journals, and opens training centers for technical personnel. So again, if you have encountered a common problem on this kind of issue with localized industry, since Ascenso naman, di ba? So, syempre, you have also the means to have other facilities for research that can help you solve your common problem. So, mupo na siya ang nakanindot for localization of industry. O, economy gains, no? Or economy gains. So, mamata kung gimension ninyo kanina, no, nga, kung daghan ganig availability of skilled labor, and then, syempre, mutaas na po ng employment rate, kaya kinanglan man silag tao nga mutrabaho sa planta, mutrabaho sa company, or mutrabaho sa factory, no? To make this and that, no, kaninga products, the it can gain larger employment opportunities, and since daghan man ang naay trabaho, no, the government can have a larger tax revenue. Kay syempre kung trabahante ka, naadyo kay tax nga i-pay, di ba? Although ang mga ordinary mamamayan gabayad man japon pud sila og tax, no, through what? Through buying products, no, like the value added tax, like mabay ka sa grocery, naman ay value-added tax. So, meaning, kung wala kay trabaho, you are still contributing to the tax. But not as much as katong na ay trabaho, Jude. Diba? So, kung daghan ang na ay trabaho, daghan po ang tax revenue sa government. And that can help sustain the economy. No? That can also help provide more opportunities po for development of infrastructures. No? Kuya lang kung dili lang, syempre, kung dili lang ibulsa, no, kanang mga ingana. So anyway, that is on another lesson ako, no, ang government and politics and governance. So anyway, let's now proceed to disadvantages of localization. So it's almost 7:30, but we will just proceed with the discussion because this is the last part of the discussion, no? Like the last discussion, 1 hour lang ta. 1 hour raman ang lesson 5. So, kung naay advantages si localization, na po try disadvantage, no? Ang disadvantage niya, syempre, dependence. So, meaning magsalig na lang ka, no? So, when an industry is localized in a particular locality, it makes the economy dependent for its requirements of the products manufactured there. I'll give an example of how bad it would be, no? Localized industry is good. It helps people have jobs, contributes to the economy. Pero if you depend it to that certain region lang, napon na siya disadvantage. So take for example, tayo butang ha, si Philippines, nag-depend lang dyan siya ni Negros Occidental to supply sugar, for example. No? Or a certain region, mag-depend lang siya aning a certain region for sugar. Wala sila ga-consider sa other regions for sugar plantation. So, purely in that one region alone. Now, matabo either na ay natural disaster or war. Nga, maguba na siya tanan ang sugar plantation. What will happen to the sugar supply of the Philippines? Syempre, ma-affected. Mumahal. Diba? Tabo sa sibuyas, no? Mumahal. Kay, we do not know if when pata makabalik og produce og sugar aning usa ka region kay naguba tungod sa natural disaster, kung gikaon abi or nabahaan or unsa, no, nabagyuhan. What will happen? Mo expensive na siya or mo export ta sa lain nga country, which is make it more expensive pa jud. So ending, magsuffer ang usa ka country. Either malessen ilang supply of sugar, ma-expensive na siya, and what will happen, no, ang kanang mga palamig or other nga mga desserts, no, either malasay na siya, no, or bland na, walay flavor, or mumahal na po siya. Kaya syempre, basic man po na siya nga ingredient ang sugar sa luto or baking, di ba? Mupo na, no, and then ang uban, proceed na lang sila magic sugar, which is dangerous for health, no? So, mupo na siya ang other na pod nga disadvantage, no, if you depend on just one region for producing a kind of product. Dapat lapta. Although, ito'y butang si Negros Occidental dyan ang main producer or major producer of sugar, pwede po na i-extend sa uban nga regions outside of Region 6. So that, ngayon kaso nga, may matabo, for example, si Bacolod, sa sugar industry sa Negros Occidental, o at least na pa other regions nag-produce ng sugar. Diba? So, mo po na. Social problems. Localization of industries in a particular locality creates many social problems such as congestion, emergence of slums, accidents, strikes, and etc. These adversely affect the efficiency of labor and the productive ability of the industry. So, social problems, no? Like, muna, no? Since daghan, like, panatabo sa Manila, sa Cebu, since daghan na mag mga localized industry, atong ibutang, kanisya nga, daghanag mga factories, daghanag mga industries, gipang tukod, so daghanag mo flock dito, masking dili taga Negros, dili taga Cebu, mubalhin ana nga lugar, kay daghag job opportunities. Ang matabo, no, congestion, yung tag-congestion gani, maghuot, mabitaw na nga traffic kaayo, no, kabantay mo, katong sa Cebu, basta gani, mamuuli na, basta Semana Santa or Christmas, mingaw kayo ang dalan sa Cebu. Kay majority of the people there are not really living in Cebu. Some of them are living outside of Cebu and are just traveling to the city for job opportunities. Same goes with Manila. Pero once gani time for them to go home to their respective families, magkamingaw ang lugar. Kay di pa man sila mutrabaho, di ba? There's no need for them to go to that certain place, no? And then, nakapait po ano, no? Not only raba ang job opportunities ang reason nga no magka-congestion ang usa ka lugar. Take for example, ning asenso ang usa ka region kay biggest producer sila of lumber. And then, daghan na nagtrito for trabaho. Nagtukod og mga dagko ng mga eskwelahan, dagko ng mga banks, infrastructures nga nindot, just like what is happening in Cebu. Tendency, those who are living in other provinces nga walay facilities ing ana sa ilaha would travel to that city to go to school, mabitaw na nga na uban, tudyog Cebu muskwila, or go there for health reasons like healthcare, kay mas asensado ang ilahang healthcare facilities dito, kay dagko ka ilahang mga kuan dito, no? Mga infrastructures, mo na example. Kay, basta naagan yung source of income sa kasyudad, like, dagko nga factory, dagko nga industry, nga daghag makatrabaho, sooner or later, mo asenso po na ang syudad na yung mga eskwelahan ipatukod. Namubitaw na here in San Carlos, although we're not as big as other cities sa Negros Occidental, pero every time that I, like katong I was still studying in Cebu, no, pagbalik na ako diri for so many years, nakita na ko nga naan na yung mga gipatukod nga bagong mall, bagong nga mga infrastructure, na na yung mga gagmay nga BPO companies, no, niya, na na university, no, na ano yung mga other mga facilities and all, because nakita nila nga daghan na mag job opportunities diri, no, people have stable income, muna nga mudag ko pa ng mga infrastructures, okay, so mo po na disadvantage because of that mo asenso nagan pug mo agtuan nga lugar, no, mo bitaw na nga naani mga slums, accidents, traffic congestion, no, because of the rapid, no, growth of the industry. And then, limited employment, no? Una, advantage ang employment, diba? Pero, again, no? If an industry is localized, employment opportunities are only limited to a particular type of labor. Okay, for example, kung ano, kanang kinahanglan lang mi o kanang mga factory workers, kay mora ni kulang yung kaysa mo, kay daghan naman kay tao, diri good, no? Nya, daghan na kay naagto, diri. Siyempre, we do not need naman any more people working in offices or people working in banks, in schools, because since daghan naman may population diri, there is no need for us to hire more. Ang kulang rana mo is a factory, kaya syempre, gadako ang factory, need me og employees. Ang nakapait lang, no, kay limited employment, so kana ra nga specific particular type of labor ra, ang kinahanglan nun, no, ang opportunity niya limited only to one. Okay? At the same time, mahutdan po ni mong employment opportunities maski usap pa kadako sa syudad. Given nga, kung nagkadako ang syudad, nagkadako po ng population. Not unless ikaw na dyan sa pinakasugod, no? Nga na dyan ka dira when it started. Advantage para ni mo. And then this economy, so with the way of time, the focus of industries in a meticulous place, economies of scale might give path to these economies. Transport, restricted access emerge, the recurrent power breakdowns. So syempre, daghan kaayo og mga tao, very congested na, so meaning transport restricted access emerge, like there's too much transportation, or na yung mga recurrent power breakdowns kay di naka-support sa kadaghag balay, no? Di naka-support, di naka-kadaog ang electricity anang place, di ba? So, di na po siya suitable, no? Kay personal sa Cebu o sa Manila nga very congested, no? Either pa may mag-run out, no? Or walay tubig, or traffic po kaayo, no? Po na siya. Okay, so the next one is regional imbalance. So focus of industries in one region or locality leads to the top-sided development of the fiscal. When one industry is localized in a region, it attracts more businessmen who establish other industries there since the accessibility of the infrastructure facilities like power, transport, finance, labor, etc. Thus, such regions improve more whilst the other areas linger backward. So meaning, syempre, no, more other businessmen would try to focus on like Cebu alone or on Iloilo or in Manila alone because it's a bigger city, it's an established one. So na regional imbalance, no. So ang uban nagka-improve, ang uban galinger backward because ang focus man sa businessman dito man sila sa more established cities, more established localized industry. And that is it for the advantages and disadvantages of localized industries. So localization in industries, to be exact, it's far different from what we discussed from last time. Lesson 3 and 4 talks about localization in business. From a global perspective, you have to narrow it down, adapt it to a regional perspective. While this one, it's more on each region, each geographic location has their own localized industry or specialty, which is they are a major exporter, they are a major producer of, and why is it an advantage and also a disadvantage to the community. Okay, so again, no, 1 hour naman ang ato ang discussion for tonight. That is actually the end of our lesson 5, which is under chapter 1. So, meaning, ana, no, our next na po nga discussion will be on globalization, which will be siguro mga next week pa, because again, we will just follow the schedule of synchronous asynchronous class, alternate lang siya, no? Okay.